everybody. Rhys Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Think of these names. Osi Umenyiori, DeMarcus Ware, T.Y. Hilton. All of them before becoming pros, starred in the Sun Belt. The Sun Belt might be one of the best-kept secrets in college football. Time to let you in on the secret. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half. Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Turner has the ball set how he wants it, and we're just about ready to kick this game off, folks. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. He's taken down. That's the 23. Well, the crowd has been waiting for him all day. Carroll's big playability about to be on display in front of the home crowd here. He's set to take his first snap as he brings the offense out, Kirk.
And, Brad, this kid's reputation precedes him. The entire offense is designed around him. As his performance goes, so will his age. Let's see what he can do in front of this big crowd. Just a complete leader.
This kid's a great player. We're not talking just about his own conference, but right now he's seeing national attention because of what he's done in conference play. Receiver, and he can't hang on.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith in your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
From their own 24-yard line, it's third down. They'll bring him down to the 37-yard line. How about that conversion on third down?
Good push here by the guys up front, and they are really starting to work hard in the trenches. Fred, I noticed during practice this week that this linebacker may be a wide receiver or running back at heart. Messing around during practice with some of the offensive skill players really it pays off for him here, as he's able to show enough instincts here to be able to knock that ball away.
Bought him, and they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately, taking back a yard.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
That brings us 3rd and 10.
Tackles him hard at the 31. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
Fourth and long here after the sack. The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. Didn't get all of that one. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. They go to the left for a nice game.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it 2nd and 6.
He gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46.
The crowd of this stadium, always a factor in a football game.
There's a strike complete.
He's on the run.
Put down in the open field. So the offense fails to pick up a first down.
And again, they provided great pressure on the play, and the offense just wasn't able to get the first down.
The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
This is a fun game,
and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over.
Makes it to the 22-yard line.
Gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
Quick strike to the receiver. He's to the 40. He's tackled at the 45-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it to make a catch.
Throws a strike over the middle, and down he goes around the 41-yard line.
Fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Quick throw off the receiver. Tackle made right around the 30. Hits him hard at the 21.
That brings up second and one.
Play is number 8 on the drive. Zips it out and it's the tight end again. Tackle at the 13.
Third down.
Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. This to try to put his team up by a field goal. Kicks up. And they tack on 3 points. They line up to kick this one away. Fielded at the 9. He's out to the 30. I'm not sure anybody loves the energy in this place like you and I do, except this team, and they're feeding off it right now.
They sure are. Every single time they play in front of this crowd, they just play with an attitude, kind of a chip on their shoulder. They're off to a great start. Let's see how they do here on this next possession.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind. They just need to go out there and play. And a quick throw. He's taken down at the 42-yard line.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Big opening. Brought down
at about the 49.
Gain of 9 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Six-yard line.
He's really playing at a whole nother level right now. I knew he was talented, but I couldn't have told you he'd come out and dominate the first half like this.
Down and they need to get it to the 15.
Well, Kirk, good news.
We saw him go to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, but he's on luck. It looks like he's going to come back in the next game.
And he's taken down around the 21-yard line.
This is for the tie. The kick is up, and it splits the uprights. Turner is lined up to kick this one off. He'll return it from the three. At the 30. They'll bring him down. It's the 45.
We talk about our meeting this week with the defensive coordinator, Kirk, and this is what they were hoping for, that they can control the line of scrimmage.
These players must have been listening pretty intently, because that's exactly what we've seen. These defenses have come out. They've controlled things early, trying to just set the tone. It's really going to be up to both of these offenses to try to make some adjustments and try to be able to come after them in some way.
Fires out to his wideout, and they make the stop.
Around the 40-yard line.
Second and 10. From the 40-yard line, it's second down. And he's tackled at about the 41.
Calling a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it third and 11.
Played one. 3-3 tie. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we've got a tight ball game.
Sack him. The pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
The punter is going to try to pin him deep in their own territory with a good punt here.
Now that's how it's done. How many times do we see punters boot it too far and it goes into the end zone for a touchback? This time, he put it up perfectly to pin him deep.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Now bring him down
around the 3-yard line.
He finds a hand for a 2-yard gain.
good stop there by the freshman.
You got to be careful with this offensive attack because one missed tackle could mean trouble.
They come out on a goal line set. Looks like they didn't get the playoff quick enough.
Delayed game. Offense.
Looked like they might have been a little bit late getting the play in, and it results in a delay of game. Second down. And as they come up to the line, they're going to be in the shadow of their own goalpost. He's got a run in the backfield. And the fullback plows ahead for maybe a yard.
The offensive line has got to do a better job of making space because that was just a punishing hit.
They're packed in tight on the line.
And he's leveled to the 4-yard line.
That brings us fourth and seven.
Gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Morris
makes it at the 49.
He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes to give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Passes, and it's almost picked off.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 33-yard line, second down. Gets out to about the 31.
That's a good gain of 2 yards. That'll bring him third and 8.
With a sack.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator.
He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Tries to thread the needle, and it's not going to work.
And now he's got room to run,
and he's got the touchdown.
Shot here by the defender breaking on the ball and taking it to the house.
Man, those pick sixes can really hurt an offense and have a lasting impact.
And he tacks on the extra point. Has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 23-yard line.
Right, everywhere we go when we travel all over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread or the pistol, and hurry up tempo offense and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing great defense. And when it's all said and done, the teams that advance and get to the important bowl games and do well in the postseason are teams that have this kind of defense.
And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line.
That brings up second and 9.
Got it. And he goes goes down quickly.
Gain of 6 yards. That makes it 3rd and 3.
The intimidation factor is definitely here when you're playing in this stadium. Throws quickly back to the tight end.
He's tackled at about the 39-yard line.
That makes it 1st and 10.
Gets to about the 41-yard line.
To convert here on another 3rd down.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers. And down he goes, around the 44-yard line.
Jackson's on top of the 44-yard line. 1st down.
5 wide. Around the 33-yard line.
That's a gain of 11 on the play. 1st down.
Tackle at the 25-yard line.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. That makes it 2nd and 2.
They'll spread the field with 5 wide.
You know, there's a reason why this guy gets all the honors. It's because he makes great plays like this look routine.
They've looked good so far on 3rd down in this drive. Let's see what happens here. Complete. He's got room. He's taken down at the 21-yard line.
Gaining 8 yards. That makes it 1st and 10.
Gets it. He's in space. Inside the 10. Now it's 1st and goal as he's knocked out after a nice game.
That makes it 1st and goal.
Throws to the receiver. He's got it again. So they go in the air, and they come away with 6, Kirk.
Man, Brad, I got to tell you, that's not an easy thing to do there. The defenses nowadays are so tough when you get inside the red zone.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he adds an extra point. A 12-play, 78-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
This one's all even at 10.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Trying to get into the tight end, but it falls to the ground.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver and maybe every other member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
Passes that, gets it out to the halfback. And he is drilled at the 32.
Just as makes the tackle at the 32-yard line. That makes it 3rd and 3.
Middle, got his back. Brought down at about the 37-yard line. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Second down and 7. Ball on the 40-yard line. Now he's flushed, and they got it.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
Makes it 3rd and 11.
He's knocked out of bounds.
Right around the 44-yard line. Myron is back awaiting the punt. He makes it to the 35-yard line.
Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, and into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
They got into the end zone last time. Let's see if they can match that on this possession.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
Wide open receiver, and it's incomplete.
Johnson's intended receiver.
From their own 35-yard line. Second down.
Quarterback
all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. And he's taken down at the 44-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards.
They go back to him on a quick throw.
And he hits him hard at the 33-yard line.
The offense calls a timeout, and they've got 2 remaining.
First down,
10 to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 25. The offense calls a timeout, and now they've only got 1 remaining. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Great pressure on the quarterback, forced that incompletion.
They really pounded him on that throw.
3rd down again. Becoming the 12th man, the crowd is always into it here. Quick out to his receiver.
He's all the way home. Touchdown.
Almost impossible pass to defend, and it goes for 6.
Yep, the defense would have needed 12 guys on the field that time.
And he hits the PAT.
It was a 6-play, 65-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right play.
Turner has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep.
Fields it at the 1,
and he's taken down at the 29. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. They'll work the right side. Nice run, and he's brought down. The offense calls a timeout. They're about 4 yards away here on 2nd down. They come out in a 5 wide set. Fires complete over the middle. And they make the stop at the 40. The offense calls a timeout. Incomplete. We're going to halftime, and we've got a great game.
17-10.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan.
Innovation
that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being. And we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got to go the big screen on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit. But great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf in
there? Yeah, if they've got some... on that second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin.
It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
This offense has found the end zone on their last 2 drives, and they're coming out on this one trying to do much of the same.
Nice run there.
That makes it 6-6.
Around the 37-yard line.
Number 47 makes the tackle. The 37-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Showing you why teams hate to come here, folks.
They'll bring him down at the 49-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. First down.
To that quickly. And he tackles him hard. At the 42.
Gain of 9 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 2.
It's 2nd down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line.
To about the 31-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. First down.
Time
Conley on the inside handoff, and they got to him before he could get back to the line. Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Boy, what great play recognition by this linebacker. He saw the run was coming, and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
Second down and 12. Ball on the 32-yard line. Gets it to his tailback, and they push him out at the 24.
That's a deep end on the play. That makes it third and three.
He's into the open field. Gains his way to the 10-yard line.
14 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Here's an opening. He's pushed out of bounds at the 4.
That's a 2-6 on the play. That'll bring up second and
13th play of the drive coming up. Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. And they'll bring him down behind the line. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
Always a noisy place to play and tough on the offense. Tries to pitch it, and now the ball is loose. The ball on it. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball.
And great awareness by the defense to jump on.
And they'll take over inside the 5. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. There's a missed tackle. They bring their quarterback down.
No gain. That'll bring up second and 11.
Decent run here, right side. So he holds on to it and gets a good 5 yards. Now he's scrambling. He's tackled around the 18-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 4th and 4.
Lott is the punter. Myron fields it at the 46. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. So the offense comes out after their last drive, had the ball end up in the defense's hands by way of a fumble.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Fires that quickly, incomplete.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 46-yard line, it's second down. And this is going to be a first down. And down he goes at about the 33-yard line.
First down.
To about the 24-yard line.
Gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and 1.
Steps out of bounds at the 21. So he finds his receiver for a short gain and a first down.
Nice throw and catch there to get past the sticks.
Thank you. gets out to about the 18-yard line. Defense coming to the line. They'd like to force another red zone fumble and 2 points off the scoreboard here. And they get nice yardage on that one.
First and goal.
Up by seven and looking at first and goal. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do quarterback.
That's a game of three. That brings in second and goal.
That was a very good all-around effort.
The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score. And he adds the extra point. A 9-play, 47-yard drive. And they come away with 7 points. Turner, ready to kick. He's to the 20. He gets hit out of bounds.
At about the 39-yard line.
You know, this defense played so well in the first half. I was very impressed. I know that. And I couldn't be more impressed with how they carried it over to the third quarter.
Well, the most impressive thing is the way they've been able to maintain that into this second half. They played lights out in the first half, but they just seem to be getting better as this game goes on.
Gets to about the 41-yard line.
That's good for gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and nine. I'm here all day.
A quarter to go, and can they pull the upset? 24-10. This very brutal fourth quarter. He's out of bounds
around the 24-yard line.
Howard gets him about 3 yards with a completion.
That'll make it their new five.
Slings it.
Tackle at the 10-yard line.
Oh, picked up about 5 yards on that hookup.
And that's just great execution on that short pass play.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. First and goal, and they'd love to get into the end zone and make this a game again. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. And And he's shoved out of bounds.
Around the 6-yard line.
Good for a gain of 4 yards. That brings up second and goal.
Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain. He's in the end zone. Touchdown. The halfback just plowed his way into the end zone.
Yeah, but it wasn't all him. The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
He splits the uprights for the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Fielded at the 9. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 34-yard line.
Well, at times like this where you have to be a team, not an individual, because it's lopsided, but it's a close game.
This is where you only can tell truly who's going to win this game if you're downstairs and looking into the eyes of these players. Because you have one team that should be up big. Where are they emotionally? And you have another team that's lucky to be in this game. Are they the team that's going to catch this head and win this football game? Right.
Couldn't hang on here in the fourth quarter. From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He's at the 40, fires in a hurry, interception, and he's taken down at the 40-yard line.
What is he thinking? The quarterback has got to know at this time in the game, unless his man is wide open, he should just throw it away. It's these kinds of mistakes that can cost you a game.
From the 40-yard line, it's first down. He makes his way to about the 32.
That makes it 7-2.
Complete for about 7 yards and first down.
How about the poise of this quarterback to locate his receiver past his sticks and get him the ball? That was a great throw.
When you've got a quarterback making throws that quickly, the defense doesn't have a lot of time to react to the play. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's another first down. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in.
Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep in their own territory.
They go right back to him, and this time they get him in the backfield.
A loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
The stop
around the 1 yard line.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Defense and their short yardage packing. He's taken down just outside the goal line.
That brings up second and goal.
Touchdowns on the ground today.
When Heisman voters are trying to decide who will get their support, they're going to be thinking about performances like this one he's having here today.
We'll be tied with the extra point, and he hits the PAT. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese,
the Bulldogs were ranked 18th. They hope this victory will push them even higher. And for Georgia, the win today
sends them off to a bowl.
And for Bryant, he powered his way into the end zone for 2 touchdowns.
Georgia takes the one-point win. In other action, the Aggies came into today's game ranked number one in the land, and they silenced any doubters with that performance. And for Texas A&M, their hot streak continues. The Aggies victorious by 14.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. From the 8-yard line, he's out to the 30. Knocked out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. They come out on an empty backfield. And he's tackled at the 48-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 38. You expect this every time you're here, and you're never disappointed. This crowd is amazing. He might not be able to get the pass off. Got it on the quick throw. And they push him out around the 35-yard line. First down. Just under three to go in regulation. Just throws this one away. Second down, 10 yards to go.
Ball in the 35.
He gets rid of this one. And this crowd is going absolutely crazy. Now bring him down.
Around the 34-yard line.
It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Great stand by the defense, and they get it back for their offense. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked. That's a loss of 10 on the play. That'll make it second and long. Quick strike, and he drops it. From their own 24-yard line. Third down. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Sets up a screen. Tillback's got it. He's tackled around the 49-yard line.
Yards on the play. That makes it 37.
And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. He's going to try and scramble. He's pushed out of bounds at the 21-yard line. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Wants to throw outside. Jackson's intended receiver on the play. From the 21-yard line.
Second down.
Wide open. Incomplete.
Oh, was the intention to see the run play.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive. This looks like their last shot to get it to the end zone. Tremendous job by that defense, and their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ball game. And now the offense has got a chance to win it. So they're going to go for it here. Well, that's just unbelievable defense. Tie game, stop that big. This late in the ball game, it looks like it's inevitable we're going to overtime. Well, we've had fun, folks, but we're not done yet because this game is heading to overtime. Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime. Quick strike to the receiver, and he's tackled right away.
At the 16-yard line. That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. The 10, the 5, and he gets the touchdown.
What it's all about in college football. I score, now let's see if you can respond. Great teams always find a way to come through.
Danny converts the extra points. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 25. Left, the running back's got it. They'll drop him for a loss. And they'll lose a yard there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
From the 26-yard line.
Second down.
Third and 11. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. Tackle made at the 22.
At the 22-yard line.
So they'll get one last stab at tying this up. We'll be right back.